Hello and welcome to Wanderland. Today we are in Reading at the Slug and Lettuce and we're going to have a bottomless brunch. But what makes this bottomless brunch special is that they are featuring music from Taylor Swift and Harry Styles. So this should be a very funny brunch today. So join me down the rabbit hole as we experience it together. Well, look who I found. David's back. What are we going to do today?
I think bottomless brunch. Would that be a good idea?
That sounds like a good idea to me.
Excellent. Food and alcohol. What more could you want?
Who are you looking forward to hearing more of, Taylor or Harry?
It's going to be Taylor Swift. Sorry.
He's a Swiftie. So here is our table at our brunch today. Oh yeah, let's see. Perfect. Oh, well, he's got some glasses as well. Here we go.
We got glasses. Oh yeah.
Oh. You've got a cord right there and you've got a face too.
Well, I do have a face, but I don't think it's going to fit with this.
And there you have it. So here is our table today at brunch. We've got our glasses of Prosecco.
A couple of complimentary shots.
We have a couple of complimentary shots. Are we having those? David has a Harry Styles mask. And I've got a Taylor Swift mask. And we both have these little heart sunglasses. David's already in the spirit. Look at it. Woohoo! There he is. Oh my word. It's going to be funny. So here we go.
Cheers.
Cheers. Strawberry milky.
Yeah, it's like strawberry milkshake. Nice though.
Nice.
Alcoholic, you can tell.
Hello and welcome back to Wonderland. Today we're at the Slug and Lettuce, like I said before. And we've got David here today. And here's the silliest bit. It is a Taylor Swift and a Harry Styles day. So I don't know how much of this music you're going to be able to listen to because of copyright, but it's a bottomless brunch and we're going to bring it to you. Cheers.
Cheers.
So yes, I'm expecting it's going to be very much like a wonderful Slug and Lettuce brunch like it usually is, but with the addition with some fun music. Yeah.
Definitely so, a lot of fun music, but also a comparison of the food.
Yes, a comparison of the other Slug and Lettuce, definitely, that we had a few months ago.
Yep.
So that will be nice, but all in all, this is going to be a fun brunch, I think.
I think so.
Yay!
Cheers.
So the problem with Harry Styles is
funny.
It's very two-dimensional.
I wanted to show you the brunch menu. It looks like this. So it's generally just like the normal bottomless brunches. So you pick your brunch, they have waffle and eggs, house breakfast, which would be like a full English, a plant-based breakfast, banoffee brioche, donut and waffle stack, a berry pancake tacos, sausage sandwich, avocado and focaccia toast, a Slug and Lettuce Mexican brunch, a bacon cheeseburger, but mushroom and halloumi burger, mushroom and cheeseburger, so vegetarian cheese, buttermilk coated chicken burger. And they are, it's, your brunch is going to be 33 pounds a person and it's available for 2 hours. So tell me, David, do you have your timer on? He has his timer.
I know what I'm doing.
He knows
what
he's
doing. It's not my first rodeo.
Not his first rodeo. So do you love this hat? I'm not sure what I'm supposed to be doing with this, but that's the deal. I don't know what to say about it.
I'm guessing putting it on your head is probably what you're supposed to be doing with it.
Mm-hmm.
Captain Obvious.
Yeah. So I'm noticing that I'm sitting here and singing to myself. This is going to be a very interesting video and I apologize, definitely. So we're trying a new medium today. We are filming exclusively on the iPhone with a brand new gimbal. So if we have some crazy filming scenes, you'll understand what's going on. But beyond that, he's killing me. He's killing me. I'm feeling 22. He's saying, I'm feeling sweaty too. What do you do? What do you do with this guy?
I ruin her lyrics. She listens to songs and I tell her what I think they do.
For my brunch dish, I have ordered a avocado on focaccia toast, and it has a poached egg, and I asked for bacon as well as hollandaise sauce. So I am going to be able to get an egg benedict, a little bit around the proper way of having on the menu, if that makes any sense. And David, what did you order, honey?
English breakfast. However, I am going to have bacon instead of hash brown. They said they could do that for me, which is always nice. I'm not a hash brown fan.
So here is David's full English breakfast. I will let him tell you what it is. Honey, what do you have?
So I have the incredibly long named two sausages.
Jelly hog.
Yeah, Jimmy Hog. And I got more bacon because I don't like hash browns. We've got the mushrooms with tomatoes on. Very fancy. I like the way that's displayed. Fried egg. They didn't actually ask me about the egg. I might have wanted it poached. I might have wanted it scrambled. But they didn't ask. They just assumed fried. So I got this one again. And baked beans. Now, again, the baked beans, I could have had the alternative option of a spicy baked beans. They didn't ask. They just assumed. So, yeah, very nice. I mean, I'm happy with everything. Don't worry.
Cool.
I'm very happy with everything, so we'll see how it goes.
Very good. Thank you very much. And here's another view of his breakfast. So I just received my breakfast, and it is avocado toast. Ooh, this is random. Avocado toast on focaccia, which I thought it would be on it, but it's kind of beside it. And there's a lot of stuff going on here. It has a poached egg and bacon. And a side of hollandaise, because I was working towards a eggs benedict, but this is a very, very unique eggs benedict. But I think I'll make it work because, you know what? I like toast, I like bacon, I like avocado, and I love hollandaise. So we're gonna try it out and I'll tell you how it is. Just looking at my breakfast right now, and my avocado has really been setting out for a very long time. I know it will probably taste nice, but just be aware, it is incredibly brown. Incredibly, incredibly brown. How is your meal so far? Have we found you with your mouth full?
Always with my mouth full.
Excellent. Good so far?
I'm very happy.
Yay! All right, sweetheart, what did you think about this Taylor Swift, Harry Styles brunch? How was your food? And tell me about the music.
Well, let's start off with the food. You know, I always do it by the sausages. The sausages were gorgeous. When I tasted the first sausage, I did think it was a little bit salty. And then I thought, get over yourself, David. I'm having streaky bacon here. What do you think's going to happen with this food? So, yeah, the sausages were lovely. They were actually, yeah, probably one of the nicest I've had, or at least up there with the top ones that I've had in these places.
Jelly Hog sausages.
Jelly Hog sausages, very good. Woo-hoo! Definitely recommend those. Everything else was great. I'd say I'm a size kind of guy.
Right. Well,
I like quantity over quality sometimes. I am quite bad. Yes, I finished my plate up. I don't feel that full, which is different than the slug of lettuce we had on Friday Street, which I definitely felt full after. And also from All Bar One, which I also felt full after. I don't feel quite full here.
What was missing?
I think it was. They were trying a little bit too hard. They were trying to be, what's the word I'm looking for?
Bougie.
They're kind of bougie. Bougie.
Bougie. Bougie.
They're trying to be bougie.
What? And tell me about your tomatoes.
About my what?
Your tomatoes.
Oh, tomatoes. I said potatoes. About my tomatoes. Tomatoes in English. Tomatoes, they were sun-dried, I think. So instead of having a full half of tomato that's been grilled and nice, it was just those were there. They were more
they were more for show than actual part of the meal. I mean, it was just a little.
Hold it.
So we had a really nice time here at the Slug and Lettuce Riverside for Bottomless Brunch. It was good. I had a good time. Did you?
Yeah, I enjoyed it. The food was really nice, actually.
It was different, definitely, from the Slug and Lettuce, the Friar's Street here in Reading. So it's always a little different. I've heard that they have changed their menus, which is fine. You know, you want to keep up on trends and everything. But my brunch was nice, with the addition of the basil oil. I've not had that with Eggs Benedict, but I had a makeshift Eggs Benedict. So how was your brunch? What did you think?
So the breakfast was really great. It was only actually when I was kind of halfway through that I realized I had no toast. Normally you get toast at breakfast, but there was no toast. That's fine.
Carb-free, man.
Because I really need carb-free. Yeah, I really...
Or so you really much. Care about it, right?
I care about that so much.
So much.
It was always better sausages. Sausages were good.
Jolly Hog.
That makes it. I prefer...
We love Jolly Hog. Sponsor us, Jolly Hog.
I prefer back bacon, the streaky bacon, but I'm happy with that. Yeah, but without the toast, it was missing something without the toast.
The crunch, I keep telling him, the crunch. You have to have the crunch.
Yeah, it wasn't, I mean, yeah, the crunch, absolutely, but I think there was also a bit of...
The crunch. The oomph.
Yeah, I'm not going to get past this, so let's just go with that.
Yeah. So mine was very nice. It was on a tiny little plate, which was fine. I had my makeshift Eggs Benedict because I want Eggs Benedict on the weekend. So I had focaccia bread, which was spongy, which is everything against what I want for Eggs Benedict. Usually I want my muffin completely toasted. But the focaccia, it was fine. It soaked up all the nice poached egg and hollandaise. And I added streaky bacon because, you know what? I am American. I like the fat of the streaky bacon. Oh, fun song. Okay, but beyond that, beyond the brown avocado, there was a lot of avocado.
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 Very British.
But... a lot of avocado, which is really a treat. It was nice and soft and beautiful. Yeah, all in all, a really, really nice brunch. I would recommend Slug and Lettuce for a brunch. I mean, would you? I mean, it's, what is it, £33 a person with bottomless drinks. And you have more than just Prosecco. You can have cocktails and everything too, but yeah.
Slug and Lettuce, absolutely recommend. Would I come back? Yes, definitely. Every
we'll be
time,
back.
Definitely
yeah.
come back.
Obviously.
I would, however, go back to the Slug and Lettuce on Friar Street rather than the one on what I call the Strip, which is the main front. I don't know what it's called. Oh, the Oracle front. Just because I think they try harder and it's bigger and it's... There was more food. I'm a kind of quantity over quality guy. There was more food. So, I love you. I would definitely come back to the Slug and Lettuce. Loved it. But I'd probably go back to Friars rather than this one.
Yeah, I would too. But we've had such a fun time with the music. So, yeah. If there is a time that you are at All Bar One, no, we're not there. We're at Slug and Lettuce. If there is a time... Bottomless Brunch. Yay! If there is a time that you are at the Slug and Lettuce, and it's like holiday time, which it is, we are at, what is it? It's not Labor Day. What are we at? The end
Sunday.
Of summer. The end of summer.
The bank holiday
bank
tomorrow.
Holiday. Yes. Recovery.
So, the recovery day tomorrow. Because while we will stop filming shortly, we will not stop drinking.
He's going to make me make him a bacon sandwich.
Tomorrow?
Yeah.
Yeah. I've got a special ticket at home. If I want a bacon sandwich anytime I want, I've got a ticket. I just give it to the ticket and I get a bacon sandwich.
Apparently, I have one job. One job. There you go.
You can stay if you do that job.
I love you.
I love you too.
I love you. He's a foul man. Foul man. But anyways.
I'm being a bad boy today.
Yeah, he is. He's full of it today. But thank you very much to our Champagne Fairy. We've had a great time here at the Slug and Lettuce Riverside. Absolutely come and visit this lovely location and have a great time like what we did. So we'll see you next time.
Yeah, and if you want to be notified about any more of our videos, just subscribe and click those reminders, the little bell thing. It helps us because it just kind of says it validates that we're doing something that you want to watch, and you get notified to say, because we don't always do it on a Friday, we just kind of put things up every so often as well in between, so you get notified of those.
Yes, absolutely. So we're very close to our next milestone, so please continue to subscribe and we'll put out some really fun content for you. Thank you again for following us in Wonderland, and we'll see you next time down the rabbit hole. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.